What is the number one moving average that I pay attention to? It's a question I get asked all the time, so I want to address it here in this video. And the answer is very simple. It's 150 day moving average. It's a simple moving average, not an exponential moving average. Why? It's close enough for us, good enough for us, so we keep it at that. But I want to talk a little bit about, why the moving averages it works very well for our purposes, and maybe how you can use it as well. And we'll go through some charts in a minute, but just quickly understand that before we look at some charts, 150 moving average roughly comes down to about a 30-week moving average. So for your, what we find is that it's some of the juiciest trends are to be had within the, I'm going to say, at least 3 month to 18 month time window. And we find that the 150 moving average for assets that are not crazy volatile, if something is too volatile, you're going to have to use something maybe even longer or very, very short. But the 150 attempts to work very well for those trends. And I'm going to show you a couple of examples here so you can see how it works. And the very simple sort of analogy here is that when you break above the two that moving average, you are good to go. And when you break below it, you stay out of it for a while. We're looking at just the Nasdaq 100 here. You can see how well it respects it over time, and different assets, equities, fixed income, commodities, cryptocurrencies, currencies. And so on and so forth, have a different sort of personalities at different stages of the business cycle. And the moving averages will work better in some environments for certain assets versus others. And we found that the 150-day tends to work pretty well as long as something is actually trending. If something is just kind of going choppy nowhere, using moving average is pretty useless because it's stuck in a range. You're better off looking at a range. But if something is trending, you can see the Nasdaq here very nicely respected the 150 day. Then it broke below it. It was time to say get out, and then it was time to say get back in as it started breaking above it. And you can see how nicely that's respected. I'll bring up just another an ETF here. You can see here. Again, it's not a perfect moving average. Nothing's perfect, but you can see for the most part, when you break above it, you stay above it. You break below it, then you go below it. Resistance here, resistance here, and then sometimes when you break above it, particularly in up gaps, like happened there, you can see how then you're in a favorable bullish trend as long as you're above it. Then you break down below it. And it finds resistance, and then you break back above it, which is, as you can see, is kind of all the way to the right. So that is one of the moving averages that we heavily rely on as just a single factor analysis, right? It's all of it as a process. There's lots of different pieces of analysis, but I do think it gives people a good idea of whether something is bullish or bearish. You can see it on this chart. When you're below it, you generally are in a downtrend. When you back above it, you tend to be in an uptrend that's more reliable. So 150-day moving average, certainly something I would suggest anyone take a look at. Look at it on individual equities, whatever asset class you have. Again, we're not looking at this from an immediate gratification standpoint. These are to capture trends. And at the end of the day, with major trends of at least 3 months to maybe 18 months, that is where the money's being made, much more so than anything that's very short-term oriented from a trading perspective. So hopefully this made some sense. Hope it helps, and we'll see you again soon.